Well, hello again from lockdown. It's so encouraging to hear that you are giving up some of your time to engage with God in the Bible. We are heading back to Colossians this week, and chapter 3 is where we are heading. So let's go there now.
Since then, you have been raised with Christ. Set your hearts on things above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things. For you died, and your life is now hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. So all through our time in Colossians, we have been looking at who Jesus is. And if we are in him, we can know who we are too. And we see this again in our passage, just how look how we're described in verse 1. Since then you have been raised with Christ. So did you just see who you are? You've been raised with Christ. That's where our location is, at the right hand of God. You are where Christ is. But of course, that's pretty amazing. But how is this actually true? Because, you know, right now I know where I am. I'm sitting right in my study, and wherever you are watching this, that's where you are. How does this work then? Well, we get more of an identity check in verse 3. Have a look at that. For you died, and your life is now hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. Okay, what on earth's going on there? Well, let's have a look. I've got some pictures for you. So it works like this. Jesus physically died on the cross. Now, I don't know how to represent Jesus, so I've just got this little guy. He died on the cross to pay for our sin, and he was dead and buried. He died, but then God physically raised him in victory over sin to rule the whole world with God the Father. But we are in Christ. We're with Christ. Our identity is wrapped up with his. And so when Christ died, we are united to him spiritually. That's our spiritual self there with Christ. So when Christ died spiritually, we died too. We died in Christ. But when he was raised, we were raised too spiritually. We saw this last week, didn't we? From chapter 2. Your whole self, ruled by the flesh, was put off when you were circumcised by Christ, having been buried with him in baptism, in which you were also raised with him through your faith in the working of God who raised him from the dead. So you have been united with Christ in his death and resurrection. So this is where your true identity is. It's now hidden with Christ in God, so we can't see it. We just see where we are, you know, physically now. But our true identity is in heaven. And in the future, when Christ returns, we will appear with him in glory. Okay, so who are you? Who's your true self if you're in Christ? Well, our past is we died with Christ. Our present is we are raised with Christ. And our future is we will be with Christ in glory. So firstly, let's make sure we see ourselves as this. You know, let's not see ourselves as the businessman or the student or the mother or a boyfriend or an introvert or, you know, anything like that. That's not who you are ultimately. You died with Christ, you've been raised with Christ, and you will appear with him in glory. That is the unbelievable reality of who you are if you are in Christ. But for the rest of Colossians, this identity impacts who you are. And so let's have a look at, not just who you are, but it impacts your day-to-day life, impacts what you do, what you think about. So let's have a look back at our verses for today. Since then, you have been raised with Christ. Set your hearts on things above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. All right, so literally that first sentence is set your hearts on things above. Literally, seek the things above. Seek the above things. That's what we're to seek them out. And then when it says set your minds on things above, that's literally think the above. So we're to seek the above and think the above. That's what we're to do. And why are we to do that? Well, because we're above. In Christ, we have been raised with him. We're in the above space. And so if we are above, then we are to seek those things that are above. Are we to think on those things, the things that belong to that reality of identity? So all that we are to to pursue, all that we are to think about and dream about, is the realities of God's kingdom and the glory of God's kingdom. And if we take this to heart, if we adopt this mindset, seeking the above things, pursuing those things, thinking the above things, having our thoughts there, then it's so good for us. It's so good for us because it lifts us up from our own situation. So, you know, we're all in lockdown. We're all stuck at home, basically. If we think and desire the things above, that makes the things of this world seem that little bit more dim. As we seek holiness and loving others, when we pursue God's kingdom and God's work, when we spend time growing in our relationship with God, that can lift us up from our circumstances so that we can focus on what's eternally important. We still need to deal with the realities here. They don't just magically go away, but we can put them in perspective. We can have joy in them. We can have purpose even in these monotonous times because of what we're seeking, what we are thinking. It's also so good for us because we're aligning our behavior and our motivations and our desires with our identity. You know, we're not living a double life here. We've been raised with Christ, and so we're living out that raised life, seeking the above, thinking the above, and that's really helpful for us. So we're not going against our identity. And also it's amazing for, it's good for God because it brings him joy, it brings him glory as we live out who he has made us to be. And so we'll look at kind of more detail of what it means to seek the above things put to death the things that are of this world. That's coming up in the next few days. But for today, remember your identity. You've been raised with Christ. You're seated at the right hand of God. And that will all be finalized when Jesus returns in glory. But for now, because that's where our spiritual reality is, seek the above. Think the above. Do that today. It will give you great joy and it will give God great glory.